Welcome to this segment of the EH Walks instructional videos for the DynaPrep MDSF, the newest generation of pipe cutting and beveling split frame machine tools. The MDSF is engineered to offer greater versatility, faster setup, higher performance, and tooling savings versus competitive machines. In this video, we will be demonstrating the setup and features of the DynaPrep MDSF standard tool slide.
With the legacy tooling, one of the features with the new DynaPrep MDSF is that you can use the legacy tooling, which was all of the tooling used on the predecessor machine, the LCSF. Here you see we have an outside bevel and an inside bevel tool bit, and the standard parting blade, which comes with the MDSF. All of the different setups are shown on this sheet, and we'll set them up now. All right, to set up the double parting, remove the covers, and we are going to select our block heights. So for the legacy tooling, our tool bit height is 3/4 of an inch. And we have two spacers that come with each machine. One is 3/4 and one is 670 thousandths. All right, the two heights allow me to set one parting blade at 670. Place that in here, secure it with the screw. Take your parting blade, place it. One thing to recognize is that the locking screw is offset from center. As you can see, our block support is on one side. So when double parting, we'll want to flip our block around so that when we tighten the clamp screw, it's over the support. Now on the second slide, we'll use the taller of the two spacers, 3/4 inch. Place it into the slide and secure it. With the second optional parting blade, place it into the slide, position it, and then again, make sure to have the screw over the support. There you can see the proper setup for double parting for the legacy tooling. Now we're going to part and bevel with the legacy tooling. Here's a legacy 37.5-degree high-speed steel bit. We'll be placing that into this slide. In order to do that, we'll take one of our spacers. In this case, either one will work. We're going to use our spacer to back up our tool bit. The legacy tooling is 1/2 inch wide, and the block is 1/2 inch. And together they fit in the pocket, which is 1 inch. Put the spacer in, secure it with the screw. Place the tool bit. Position your tool bit wherever desired. Here now you can see we have an offset on the screw. We need to place the cover so that it lands over the top of the tool bit. Now we're going to place the parting blade in the second slide. We'll remove the cover. Now, since our tooling is 3/4 high, we'll want to use a spacer that's slightly shorter. So the 670 spacer gets put into the slide, secured with a screw. Place the parting blade into the slide. And again, make sure that your screw is over the support. In this case, it's best to remove this screw so as not to shake loose during machining. There you have the setup for a part and bevel using legacy tooling. Now we're going to set up a double part and bevel using the legacy tooling. I'm going to use my 37.5 degree high speed tool bit. We'll be placing that into this slide. First thing we need to do is add 3/4 inch spacer. Both pieces are 1/2 inch wide, so they fit into the 1 inch pocket. Place our spacer in and secure it with the locking screw. All right, then we'll take our 37.5 degree bit, place it in, set our desired position, take a parting blade, place it over the top, and we'll want to line the corners of the two bits up, and then place the cover back over the top, secure our bits. On the second slide, we'll be putting in our second parting blade. Now the height of our legacy tooling is 3/4 inch. So we're going to want to set this blade slightly lower. So that would be our 670 spacer. We'll take that block and place it into the slide. Secure it with the locking screw. Take our bit, place it in the slide, always make sure to put the locking screw over the support, in this case we'll want to remove this screw so it doesn't vibrate loose on us. We'll just take that out. There's the proper setup for a double part and inside bevel using legacy tooling. Now we're going to set our tool slides up to part and outside bevel using the legacy tooling. For this, we'll need the legacy outside bevel tool, parting blade, and our spacers. All right, we'll set our outside bevel tool up in this slide. Remove the cover. Use one of the smaller 1/2 inch spacers. Secure it with a locking screw. And then we'll place our outside bevel tool, set the tool to the desired position, lock it in place. All right, now we'll place our parting blade in our second slide. For this, we're going to remove the cover, and then we will be using the shorter of the two spacers, the 670. Place that into the slide. Secure it down with the locking screw. Place our parting blade in. Position it wherever we need to. Again, place the cover over, paying attention to place it over the lower support. In this case, we will remove this screw so it doesn't vibrate loose on us while machining. All right, and there you have the proper setup for a part and outside bevel using legacy tooling.
That concludes this segment on the EHWalks DynaPrep MDSF, whose performance, ease of use, and versatility is redefining the weld prep machine tool category. Look for additional videos on the setup and operation of the MDSF standard counterbore, OD tracking slides, FFC and FFR flange facing modules, and the MDSF-based ECC and EICC casing cutters. Thanks for watching.